Does science require materialism? To explore this, let's first define the scientific method, which is to ask questions based on observations, form a hypothesis that makes a prediction, test the prediction to find confirmation, and iterate the hypotheses or predictions. In short, science is the study of the behavior of matter. To better understand the scope of science, let's consider that word behavior with an analogy to video games. For a person to succeed in playing a video game, they must master the behavior of the game. They do not need to know anything about the computer hardware or software, even though the game's very existence is dependent on those fields. It turns out that this is also true for science, as the behavior of matter is independent of what matter actually is. That is the field of metaphysics, which is the study of the fundamental nature of reality, including existence. Now, materialism, which purports to explain the nature of reality, is a theory of metaphysics, and such questions lie well beyond the behavior of matter. So these two things are very distinct. But let's give it a little test. For scientists and others often assume that materialism is true, which means that consciousness would have to somehow emerge from matter. But what is the experimental data in support of this hypothesis? We all have consciousness, but have you or anyone you know ever experienced consciousness emerging from matter? No? Are there any experiments that have demonstrated this in the history of science? No. So belief in materialism is just that, a belief, remarkably held in the absence of any evidence. Now let's examine some major scientific advances. In 1801, the double slit experiment by Thomas Young demonstrated that light sometimes acts as a wave and other times as a particle. In 1927, this experiment was reproduced with electrons and later with atoms and then molecules. If you are unfamiliar with this experiment, I would invite you to follow the link above or else in the description below, for it appears to demonstrate that matter does not exist until there is an observer present to collapse the wave function. And the quantum eraser experiment, also linked, further demonstrates that particles revert back to waves when observer ambiguity is again introduced. Again, the existence of matter is tied to an observer. These results baffle materialists, which is why they tend to avoid talking about it, but founders of quantum mechanics changed their views in the face of their laboratory evidence. Max Planck said, "I regard consciousness as fundamental. I regard matter as derivative from consciousness. We cannot get behind consciousness. Everything that we talk about, everything that we regard as existing, postulates consciousness." Schrödinger said, "Consciousness cannot be accounted for in physical terms, for consciousness is absolutely fundamental. It cannot be accounted for in terms of anything else." Nikola Tesla said, "The day science begins to study non-physical phenomena, it will make more progress in one decade than in all the previous centuries of its existence." Scientific progress involves changing one's views in the face of evidence, for without confirmation, we have to iterate the hypothesis. To not do so is simply religious faith. Then in 2022, the Nobel Prize for Physics went to researchers who demonstrated that one entangled particle, when observed, impacts others instantaneously, regardless of distance or the speed of light. From Scientific American, "One of the more unsettling discoveries in the past half a century is that the universe is not locally real. In this context, real means that objects have definite properties independent of observation." So objects don't have definite properties independent, again, of observation. This is what Einstein had derisively called spooky action at a distance. But now we have further evidence that matter is observer-dependent, which is further evidence against materialism. Under quantum mechanics, nature is not locally real, meaning that matter is not what materialism would have us believe. Space-time is not fundamental. In summary, what we've established is that metaphysical theories on the nature of reality lie outside the scope of science, as the behavior of matter is altogether different than what it actually is. Also, in a previous video, we detailed a number of flaws with materialism. Let's now add to the list. There is no experimental evidence that consciousness emerges from matter. Waves of probabilities collapse into particles upon observation and return to waves when observer ambiguity is introduced. Nature is not locally real, meaning that objects don't have definite properties outside of observation. With such evidence against materialism, other metaphysical hypotheses ought to be considered, such as philosophical idealism, which is the idea that consciousness, and therefore observation, are fundamental. This theory, not solipsism or dualism, aligns well with these scientific findings, and which we will describe in more detail in future videos. Be sure to like this video and subscribe to Consciousness Squared.